In the buzz now at 9, one baseball player has his eyes set on a mermaid. John Mayberry of the Philadelphia Phillies. He used his agent to try and land a date with his beautiful actress, Antoinette Nick Perelas? I think it's
Nick Perelas.
Alrighty. Well, she plays a mermaid in the latest Pirates of the Caribbean movie. And Mayberry, he had his agent send an email to her agency asking to meet her. Well, the email somehow got leaked to Page Six.
Somehow.
Yeah. It shows the agent was less than thrilled to be making the request. And he even mentions that he's a little embarrassed that he's even asking for the actress's contact information and says he knows the agency is not a dating service. The date never happened, we need to mention. And Antoinette, the actress, she's married. But this got us thinking, you know, how did you ask your significant other out on a date? What is the weirdest way you've ever been asked out?
See, this story doesn't blow my mind. This happens all the time. Actors, yeah. You know, go talk to their, they see another actress that they like or vice versa, and they get their agent to talk to their agent. So mm-hmm. Isn't that how Tom Cruise met Katie Holmes? I mean, it's just.
Yeah. I thought that's how Brad Pitt met Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah, Halle Berry and David Justice met through their agents. I mean, it happens all the time. Yeah. I think the oddity here is that actress was married with a child.
Right.
So it was like a little odd.
Didn't he Google her and find out that information before asking
his
agent?
He probably should have.
Yeah. He probably just felt like
find out anything on
Google. No kidding.
Yeah. But he probably said, you know what? I like her. I want her. You know how it is.
All right. Well. Let's go ahead and get what you're saying. Anne-Marie Honorado writes, I was on a plane from Arizona to New York. We had a layover in Kansas. The guy next to me said, hey, you hungry? We went for a burger. That was the first date 26 years ago. Still married with 3 kids. That is so cool.
That is cool.
All right, Kenna Schlein writes, by mail, met her at camp. We went our separate ways, started riding each other, and 1 year later, we were engaged after seeing each other only 6 days. Married for 34 years now.
Oh my gosh,
wow.
That is so sweet.
And let's see.
Well, Christopher Gossett said, doesn't apply. I'm single. This guy sounds shy if he has to ask his agent to ask out a woman. Okay, ladies, Christopher Gossett is single.
some of you are putting such funny things on here. John Patterson, we can't read that. You're so silly. I'm trying to get through the dirty one.
Yoli Rector says, I was set up by my brother-in-law while visiting Phoenix. He had his work colleague take me to a concert as he knew both of us liked the band. My husband now tells me that he was so nervous, but I somehow made him feel comfortable to talk, something he never did much around women. We went on several dates, and the rest is history. Go on. She says, they fell in love. It's been 16 years.
How wonderful.
Go ahead.
Socorro Martinez says, it was my first dance at church. I was 15 years old. I had been eyeing this handsome, dark-haired 19-year-old. So I asked a friend to ask him if he would go to the dance with me, and he said yes, and we've been dancing ever since. My husband, my love.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Wow.
And you met your husband in high school.
Yeah. Well, it was kind of like Kenna Schlein's story. We met through church, and then he went away and worked at camp, and I stayed back here in Phoenix, and we wrote to each other, and then by the end of that summer, we were together. And actually, it's a funny story because he had long hair, and I don't like guys with long hair. It's just not my thing. And so he said to me, would you ever date a guy with long hair? And I was like, no. And he cut his hair off while he was at camp that summer, and then he came back with short hair, and he's like, will you go out with me?
I look different now. I actually met my husband on a blind date. We knew friends in college, and we hooked up on a blind date. It was almost a month before I ever laid eyes on this guy because we talked on the phone because he was at a different university, and I was like, you know, I really want to meet this guy. I feel like he's the one. And when we met, it was definitely kismet. It was 8 months later, we were engaged, and 15 years later, 2 kids later. It's later. So
it's funny. Well, I'm divorced, but my ex-husband, we met in high school, and it was his first day. He was the new kid, and he came in. He sat down next to me, and he says, excuse me, what time is it? I can't see the clock. I'm like, oh, yeah, whatever. You just want to talk to me. So I told him, you know, what time it was. Turns out the guy is blind as a mouse.
Rebecca was totally turning it back on herself.
Like, he still wants to talk to me, and this is his way of going about it. But, yeah.
Well, that's hilarious.
That is cute. We do.